pop using every trick. Since this channel analyzes the science of skateboarding, I've always wanted to compare various tail angles, but I don't have much money to buy so many boards. So in this video, we will examine how the tail angle affects the performance of the board using multiple methods. You can verify the tail angle of your choice using the physics simulator I will introduce in the latter part of this video. You're watching Why the Trek, please subscribe. First, I decided to make a board that I can freely adjust the tail angle. I will use a blank deck and metal fittings. The fittings can be folded in the center, and I can fix their angles by tightening its central part. And now, I've marked the exact place to cut and used this saw to cut the tail in the name of science. I'm sorry to the manufacturer of this deck. Once it's separated, you can see the layers of the deck. There were bars of wood, so I ground them off. A few bars remained, but it was enough for this experiment. Next, I drilled holes to fix the metal fittings. After installing the hardware and the grip tape, it's complete. I can now change the tail's angle freely and fix it anywhere I want. Without having to buy a new deck, I should be able to experiment with different tail angles endlessly. Now let's see how it goes. In 3, 2, 1... Sorry, didn't work. The metal fixture was too weak, and I just couldn't make it strong enough to be used in an actual skateboarding scene. And that's all for this episode. Thank you. No, it is still way too early to give up. What would be science without failure? If it's hard to create one in the real world, I can use a physics engine. So I made this, encoded that, and the system's ready. This system allows you to adjust various elements of your choice, including the angle of the tail and nose. For example, set the tail angle bigger and press a rerun button. And the system will generate the tail with the specified angle and drop a sphere on top of it. This sphere pushes down on the tail to simulate a pop. Since the position of the end of the tail changes depending on the angle, the position at which the ball falls can also be adjusted. Use the auto-aim tail function to automatically drop the sphere at the edge of the tail, as it takes some time to adjust it manually. Furthermore, I've made it possible to adjust the flow of time in the 3D world for more detailed analysis, so you can check the simulation in slow motion. Please note, some variables, such as the length and width of the board, cannot be controlled for now as it's still under development. Now, let's try this system under several conditions. It is generally said that steeper the tail angle, the higher it pops. Or, mellower the tail angle, the lighter it pops. In order to verify whether these common beliefs are true, we will conduct a comparison test using boards with a 10 degree tail angle, an 18 degree tail angle, and a 36 degree tail angle. First, let's drop a 3 kg sphere from 1.5 meters high. There was almost no difference between the 10 degree and 18 degree boards, and they flipped over to the other side. However, the 36 degree board did not flip over to the other side, and went back to its original direction. This may be because the closer the tail is to vertical, the more force transfers to the ground rather than to lift the nose. Of course, not everything in this experiment applies to the real world. Please keep in mind that the pop in the real world may contain a horizontal force and may change the way the board behaves. Plus, the ease of doing tricks is an entirely different story. When I pop the board, you can see that the nose of the 36 degree board comes up significantly higher. This should make it easier to hook the front foot and lift the board more efficiently in an ollie. And it should also make it easier to do flips. Next, let's consider the pup's lightness by reducing the sphere's weight to 1.5 kilograms. By simply comparing them, the angle of the 36 degree board seems to rise the highest, but there seems to be a hidden secret here. Let's take a closer look. The 36 degree board starts to rise the moment the sphere hits the tail. But the board's rising speed slows down and gradually stops. Immediately after that, the sphere hits the tail again, increasing the board's angle further. On the other hand, in the case of 10 degree or 18 degree boards, after the sphere hits, the tails become fulcrums, and the rear wheels leave the ground. In this state, the board's center of gravity is in the air, and you should be able to flip it by flicking out your front foot. If you compare the boards before the sphere hits the tail of the 36 degree board for the second time, all three boards are almost at the same angle, but the wheels of the 36 degree board are still on the ground. In this state, you probably won't be able to flip the board by flicking it with your front foot, indicating that the 36 degree board requires a bigger force to lift its center of gravity and allow you to control it. For these reasons, the physics engine says the common belief that you can pop the Meloa tail more lightly is correct. Now, let's increase the weight of the sphere to 4.5 kilograms in order to increase the force applied to the tail. Generally speaking, the greater the angle of the tail, the higher the board pops. But a comparison of three boards shows that the board with the 10 degree tail pops the highest. This should provoke a lot of discussions, but let's consider the reason for this. The tail of a 10 degree board is so close to the ground that the energy received from the sphere can hit the ground immediately, and its rebound directly pushes it back up into the air. On the other hand, with a 36 degree board, the tail will hit the ground only after descending a long distance, at which point the board has already lost some of its energy. If you look at the horizontal distance, you can see that the leverage principle applies. The looser the angle, the greater the distance from the fulcrum to the point of force. Thus, it can lift the nose on the opposite side of the force more effectively. Given these facts, the common saying that the greater tail angle pops higher is not necessarily correct from the standpoint of the board's bounce alone. However, in actual tricks, it is also essential to consider other elements such as the roll of the front foot and timing. For example, the 36 degree board has already risen to a greater angle than the other boards when the tail hits the ground, and would cause more friction with the front foot. We can also see the board bounces up the latest because it takes the longest time until the tail hits the ground, affecting the timing. Once again, this experiment focuses only on the board's behavior when it receives an external force on the tail. Let's see how the angle of the tail affects real skateboarding experiences when other elements are taken into account in future videos. And that's all for this episode. If there's any other feature the system should include, please give me feedback. In the next video, we will examine the science of kickflip based on the concept of the tail angle we have verified this time. Please look forward to it. As always, thank you so much for watching. Until next time.